What's up, builders? So yesterday, Voiceflow dropped their new product feature, which is the agent node. Now, I spent a few hours testing this thing, and I wanted to provide my immediate thoughts because I'm sure as I continue to go through this and test it out, I have a better idea of the functionality. But you can see now in the docs, it's been updated, build an advanced AI agent with a single prompt. So this is Voiceflow's kind of first foray into here are some training wheels. Let's throw a prompt together and get some agentic functionality. Now, if we were to rewind the clock, say 6 to 8 months ago, I was tinkering around in the OpenAI Assistance API, some other builders that were that had some of this functionality out of the box, which is this general brain that can call tools and execute functions and things of that nature, which we'll probably talk about a little more. I know I've brought up the N8N agent recently as well. So this is kind of along that same line of thinking, which we're moving from a linear flow into a more, here is a central brain that then starts routing things based on the user's input. So this is a very small agent with three nodes here, and you can see in the middle in blue here. If I drag up at the top here is the new agent node, and by clicking down this drop down, I have one agent that I have built in here, which if I click edit, here is the instruction window, which is the prompt, pretty much to guide how it handles responses inside of here. There are two input variables that I have at the bottom here, which my head is probably blocking. So one of them is last utterance, and the other is Voiceflow memory, which is a small amount of storage, only 5, 10 of the last conversation, last utterance, last response combos between the user and the agent. But yeah, this is connected to a greeting. Hi, welcome, Mr. Electric. This is, once again, this is a local electrician. Let's see this agent. Hi, where are you located? And the agent just kind of picks this up, and then you sit in the agent node, which is unique. Okay, I see I have book a job as a route. If we look at the agent, this is a path. This is a book a job path that I have added, and you enter a path name and then an LLM description for book a job. I've added trigger this when the user mentions they are interested in booking an electrician, hiring an electrician, or having a technician come to their home to diagnose a problem, which is the main call to action this agent would take if it is customer facing sitting on this website. So if I go back in here, where are you located? What services do you offer? So I can just sit here and ask it multiple questions, and each time the agent is handling each response and it is not going anywhere. It's sitting in this agent view. But if I say, oh, it's still answering this question. This is a long one. That's because the knowledge base answer to this is long. And I'll show you that here in a second. But if I say, okay, I'd like to have someone come out to my house to proceed with scheduling a visit, could you please confirm your email address? So I'll show you how it knew to ask that in a second. Put my email address. Book a job now gets routed here. Perfect. To get started, please visit this link, which if I click this book now button, just goes to the contact us page, which I just threw together quickly because this is a demo. Now, if we go back into this agent here, book a job. At the bottom here is a required variable, which means that if you are sitting inside of this agent node, asking questions, asking questions, asking questions, getting responses. Okay, this book a job intent gets picked up, but in order to continue this route, you have to capture a variable before proceeding, which is why it said, hey, give me your email address to proceed, which that's pretty useful for this particular use case. And you could, you know, add multiple variables into this path here. Right now, I just tried it with email address. I will say that there is an LLM description for this variable, which you can provide some guidance, things of that nature. I would caution you to be careful with the instructions you try to give the LLM here on processing incoming data. For example, like a statement that says verify that this is a proper email address, that's not really going to be good enough. You really should add some additional handlers onto whatever the output of this variable is and verify that this information is accurate before proceeding. But that, of course, depends on your particular use case. But anyways, the access to knowledge base toggle here. So if you don't have a knowledge base or you don't really care to query it for this particular agent's use case, you can toggle this on and off. Now, something that's interesting here, this also has an LLM description. So you're going to have to get used to, I'm going to kind of prompt the guide myself based on what is going on in all these various paths, whether it's capturing a variable, whether it's giving the knowledge base, you know, instructions, giving your agent instructions. You're kind of giving everything instructions across the board. Now, I don't know if you remember this from the AI steps back in the day, but you could have a, you know, only access the knowledge base. And if I am like pulling up some of my other workflows here, where is this example, right? So this is me making sure that I'm hitting RAG on just the knowledge base. I've got a bunch of different prompts and chaining and calling, like I'm doing all of this work to handle this. Whereas in the agent, I'm just coming in here and giving it a couple of sentences, which, depending on the use case, you might only want to get examples from the knowledge base. You don't want the LLM general knowledge coming in here and providing people answers. Now, I've attempted to guide this agent in the direction, trigger the knowledge base always as it has the answers to most questions that customers will ask. Do not provide general information or advice from your model training and only tailor responses from knowledge base information. I will tell you in the settings tab here, if we look at the prompt that I am using, I have 4.0 enabled, which seems to adhere to some of these instructions much better than 4.0 mini. 4.0 mini seemed to give me some just general instructions a little bit more frequently. And in some cases, didn't even access the knowledge base, even though I knew the answer was sitting in there. So mess around with this drop down and test out the different models based on your use case. And it only makes sense that if all of this is LLM description based, that the prompts that you are using will have an effect on how this agent actually operates in the wild. Now, something else here, in order to, we can, you know, create a new agent here, give it a name, but also, if I delete this, they have a community agent nodes here, which all of these have been built by Voiceflow. This is a brand new offering, so it makes sense that the community hasn't built any agents and put them in here. But I think this is actually going to be pretty interesting. One, it's probably worth spending a little bit of time to go in here and click through some of these and get an idea at some of the prompt structures that they're using in order to guide these agents, because maybe some of you are staring at a blank screen, or, you know, you create a new agent and this is empty and you're like, I don't know what to put in here. So these templates are probably a good starting point for some of you. Also remember that every time that you add an agent onto the canvas, it comes up in your CMS board as well. So that untitled one was me creating an agent and not doing anything. And then book appointment was a community node, whereas my Mr. Electric agent general is the one that is in use here. So what else can we discuss? Oh, why did that go away? Okay, another thing I want you to keep in mind. When I was messing around with OpenAI Assistance API, they have threads and thread memory, and even the N8N node that I showcased has an ability for you to control your memory a little bit more straightforward and throw this into Postgres. Inside of this Voiceflow agent, it does not have memory out of the box. And I will showcase this right now. So I'm going to start asking questions here. When should I replace my wiring? By the way, my name is Connor. Hi, Connor. Wiring should be replaced. Yada, yada, yada. What is your phone number? You can reach Mr. Electric, yada, yada, yada. Okay. Now, what happens if I say, what is my name again? Your name is Connor. Now, why did it know that? It knows that because in my instructions of the agent, I have Voiceflow underscore memory as a variable being passed to the agent. But remember, that is a very short buffer window that is being overridden each time you interact with the agent. So in this same conversation, I'm going to start pinging it with a bunch of different questions. Where are you located? When should I replace my electric panels? My lights are flickering in the house. What should I do? Do you have licensed electricians? Right? I'm just hammering this thing because I want to push my name out of the buffer window and showcase to you that this agent no longer knows what my name is, and that is just a function of this short-term memory variable. So if you want to construct a similar situation as Assistance API or other platforms that have this, you need to handle memory yourself, either by creating the variables, continuously updating it, shoving it into a database, however you want to handle that. You have to control that. What is my name again? I'm sorry, but I do not have access to your personal information. So in one conversation string, I can scroll all the way up here. My name is Connor. Hi, Connor. And then I come back down and I answered it 5 or 6 questions. So the 10 last utterance and last responses got kicked out. I think it's 10 total, so it's 5 of each. It no longer had my name. So keep that in mind. This is not I'm just going to drop one agent node on the screen, and it's going to be able to handle everything from start to finish and know this conversation from the get-go. It doesn't work like that. Now, something else that's interesting. In this, there are two toggles here on this agent node. One of them is listen for other intents. One of the ways to build dynamic agents in Voiceflow up to this point has been using their global intents, which is basically a listener that says, okay, I'm triggering this new workflow because the user has said something specific. I want to talk to a human. So it's like, okay, I have a specific flow I need to execute in order to hand this off through Zendesk or wherever, for example. But remember, your agent is also routing paths. So now I have global intent and paths. I have one additional workflow on this canvas, which is the ice cream test. Now, why did I pick ice cream? I just wanted an intent that has absolutely nothing to do with an electrician. So I have a trigger, which is ice cream, and I have a block that just says ice cream rocks. And if I go into my intents, yes and no is baked in. Ice cream is one I created. And I said, trigger this intent when someone mentions ice cream. It's very straightforward. Watch what happens if I come in here and we do this again. I want some ice cream. It seems like you're looking for ice cream, but you've reached Mr. Electric, a professional electric service company. Does not pick up. The global intent does not pick up at all. Now, the agent's response here, that's great. That's perfect. That's great. This might reduce the amount of guardrails that I actually have to put into some of these because it just handled this random request from an individual. So I feel like there's going to be who is the driving engine? We're going to get into the scenario where you want to route users through a conversation based on paths in the agent, but they might butt up against your global intents that you have in the canvas. So I'm interested to see one, why is this not working? Is it only in the test canvas? If I push this into production, does it actually do anything? But I know that they just put rag intents out. So there's a lot of moving parts here. But I almost wonder if I'm going to stop using workflows and triggers globally because I'm just going to hand it off to another agent. And this is kind of a decent transition point. I think this agent node should reduce the overall number of blocks that actually hit the canvas potentially. And what we end up doing is compartmentalizing agents for very specific functions, ensure that the correct interaction happens through validation, through functions, which I didn't even really get into or mess around with yet, and then hand it off down the line to another sub-agent and have almost like these specialized workflows. But even this, from a, okay, I'm a small business owner, I want something on my website to interact with customers. This is actually pretty good with not a whole lot going on from a logic complexity standpoint because the agent node is taking the brunt of handling the conversations and the use cases while still allowing routing to specific paths and things happening that you want to happen. So, for a first kind of pass through and testing this out, I'm glad to see this. I've got some builds coming up that I want to continue to test this out and try different things, and I'll be sure to make sure to kind of give you guys a heads up if I find anything useful. I would, from Voiceful aside, if I'm asking for something, maybe a little bit more clarity on how this is supposed to interact with some of the global intents and what they're seeing. But yeah. Anyways, talk to you guys soon. It just kicked me out, about to hit the dashboard. All right, talk soon.